Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through few problems related to logarithmic expressions. Let's go through these six problems. Before we get into the problems, let's recall all the logarithmic laws which is needed before even we solve the problems. The first law is log of mn. That is, if you have multiplication, then you'll have to write it as log of m plus log of n. So here you have m into n, it's going to become m plus n, log m plus log n. Multiplication, if there's multiplication, it will become addition. Similarly, log m by n. Log m by n is log m minus log n. That is, if you have division, then it will become subtraction. And third one is log m to the power n. M to the power n. That is, if you have a power, then it's going to be n into log m. N into log m. N is the power. Fourth law is change of base law. Change of base law. So if you have something like log m to the base n, then we can write it as log m to the base a by log n to the base a. This way we can write log of m by log of n to some other base, which is base a. Also, if we have 1 by log m, we can write as log n to the base m. That is, we can swap the base and the number and take a reciprocal of it. And the last one is, always remember this particular property. If you have base and the number are same, then the power is going to be 1. That is, log a to the base a is 1. Let's take a few examples from second main. We'll have to prove that this entire expression is equal to 30. Right? So, what we'll do? We'll first expand this. Log x square is nothing but 2 log x. Y cube, 3 log y. Z to the power 5, 5 log z. Right? Using the log property. Log n to the power n is equal to n log m. Next, we'll have to use change of base law. We'll have to use change of base law because if you notice, every base is different here. You have y, you have z, and you have x. The bases are different, right? When bases are different, we'll have to use this change of base law. What does it say? Log b to the base a can be written as log b by log a. Now, we'll use the same thing. Log x by log y. Log y by log z. Log z by log x. Now, if you notice, this log x and log x can be cancelled. Log y, log z, log z. Finally, you're left with 2, 3, 5. That is 30. Right? Hence, we have proved. Let's take this another example. Prove that this particular expression gives 4. We'll have to use two laws. Change of base law. Log b to the base a can be written as log b by log a. That is, we can write this in this way. Log b by log a. And 1 by log b to the base a can be written as log a to the base b. Can swap this here. Using this, we can prove this. So first, we can write this like this. 1 by log 4 can be written as log 2, 4. Let's swap it. Then log 8, 4. Then log 16, 4. We are swapping the bases. We are swapping these numbers. Right? We are swapping it here. Now, the bases are same. So we can use the addition logarithmic law, right? This is log a plus log b plus log c is nothing but log abc, right? So we can write this as log 2 into 8 into 16 to the base 4. So I can write this entire thing as log to the base 4, 2 into 8 into 16 is 256. Now let's write 256 in the multiples of 4, right? So we can write this as 4 to the power 4. 4 to the power 4. 4 multiplied 4 times, you'll get 256. Now, we can further write this as, using logarithmic law, log of m to the power n is equal to n into log m. So using this law, we'll write this as, this is going to be 4, 4 log 4 to the base 4. Now we know, if you have the base and the number same, then it's going to be 1. That is, log a to the base a is always 1. When you have this base and this number same, then it's going to be 1. So you're going to write this as 4 into 1, which is 4. And this is nothing but RHS. So in this example, we'll have to solve this particular expression. Solve means we'll have to find the value of x. So now use the logarithmic law. Log x plus log x plus 1 can be written as log x into x plus 1 using this law. Log mn is equal to log m plus log n. So log x into log x plus 1, right? So log x into x plus 1 is equal to log 2. Now since there is log on both the sides, this value should be same. X into x plus 1 is equal to 2. Right? So this value and this value should be equated. So now you shift to this side, you'll get x square plus x minus 2 is equal to 0. Now you have an equation. Using this formula is x is equal to find the value of x, you'll have to use this formula, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. A, b, c are the coefficients of x square x, right? And c is the constant. A is number next to x square. There is nothing here. So a is 1. B is number next to x. There's nothing here. So b is equal to 1. C is just the number, minus 2. Substitute all of this. Use this plus or minus. That is minus 1 plus 3, minus 1 minus 3. So use this plus or minus. You'll get two values, 1 and minus 2. So these are the values of x. X is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 2. Another example, we'll have to solve, find the value of x. Here we'll have to use change of base. Remember one thing, every time you have different bases, here you have 2, here you have 4, use the change of base law, which states that log a to the base b is log a by log b. So you can write this, split this, log x by log 2, log x by log 4. Now, try to get the same number. You have 4, make it as 2 square. So you have log 2, log 2 square. Log 2 square can be written as 2 log 2 using this property. Log m to the power n is n log m. Now you take the LCM, 2 log 2 is LCM, you will get this particular expression, this is equal to 3, right? When you simplify all of this, you are going to get this, log x is equal to 2 log 2. This 2 log 2 can be written as log 2 square using same property. So log x is log 2 square. Since both the sides there is log, x is 2 square. X is 2 square means x is 4. Let's take this problem where we have to show that x, y, z is 2. We have given the values of x, y, z. Simple. Take this x, y, z. Take this as LHS. Take this as RHS. LHS is equal to x, y, z. What is x? Instead of x, you put this. Instead of y, instead of z. Substitute all of this. Then using change of base law. See, you have different bases here. Since you have different bases, now apply the change of base law. So it's going to be log 9 by log 2. Log 7 by log 9, log 4 by log 7. Now all of this will get cancelled here. You'll be left with log 4 by log 2. You can write log 4 as log 2 square, right? And then this log 2 square can be written as 2 log 2. 2 log 2 by log 2. Log 2 log 2 will get cancelled. You're left with 2, which is nothing but equal to RHS. Hence, since LHS is equal to RHS, XYZ is equal to 2. This is proven. Now, another problem. Prove that this entire statement is true. Take this as LHS. And this is RHS. Take the LHS separately, right? You have this. Now you have log x square. You can write it as 2 log x. X cube, 3 log x. X to the power n log x. So you can take log x as common, right? Everywhere there is log x as common. Take log x as common. You'll be left with 1 plus 2 plus 3. There's nothing here, means 1. 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n, right? Now this 1 plus 2 plus 3 can be written as, there's a formula. 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n, you can write it as n into n plus 1 by 2, n into n plus 1 by 2. So instead of writing these numbers, you can write n into n plus 1 by 2 into log x. This is nothing but 1 by 2 into n plus 1 into log x, which is the RHS. Now since LHS is equal to RHS, this entire statement is proven.
With this, we have come to the end of this particular topic. If you have found this video useful, do press a like and share it. Thank you.